look around and listen when the chill of autumn settles in. You can see and hear the future of the forest literally falling at your feet.
It's really important because a lot of animals use the acorns as their food source, and so it's pretty important for that, and then also for reproducing the oaks.
Trouble is, the yearly dropping of acorns by oak trees is a ritual of fall that is so common, most people simply walk over the seeds of oak trees that cover the ground.
25 is yes. 20 is no. This 21 is yes.
But to these United States Forest Service researchers working in the Bent Creek Experimental Forest near Asheville, acorns provide a window through which to view not only the current, but also the future health of the forest.
What site are we at?
The 6,000-acre Bent Creek Forest was established in 1925. It is the oldest federal experimental forest east of the Mississippi. Forest management has been a long-term research goal. Scientists have found the lowly acorn plays a primary role in the forest ecosystem. That's the community of plants, animals, and microbes in their environment.
First of all, acorns are the seeds of oak trees, and people like to have oak trees. Also, acorns are very important for wildlife. Most of the game species, or a large number of game species, eat acorns. And if there are enough acorns in the fall for them to get nice and fat, they're more likely to survive the winter and to have more babies the following spring. If there aren't enough acorns, they're less likely to survive, and they probably will have fewer babies, so their populations go down. Another reason that acorns are important is they also feed mice. And of course, mice, or rodents, including squirrels, are the prey base for lots of other animals. So if there are a lot of acorns, there's a lot of better survival and better reproduction of mice. So the next year there's more mice, which means the raptors, the owls, the hawks, the foxes, the bobcats have more to eat.
Know the acorn, know the forest. But to do that, scientists need to know how many acorns the different species of oak trees are producing. So once a year, researchers scan the tree canopy
to see if the tree has acorns, and if it does, we try to rate the percent of the crown that is producing acorns.
That estimate of trees and acorn production is then combined with more hands-on research, and that requires physically counting acorns. And that's where these baskets, which surround dozens of oak trees, come in.
What we do is we have a standardized size of the basket, and we have three of them under each tree, which we position under the tree's crown. And so when the acorns drop, we know the number of acorns per unit area or per basket. And that way we can average them together to get the number of acorns per unit area of crown. And that way, if we know the crown size of the tree, we can say if we're getting this many in this area, we can expand it out to, and that way know how many are produced in the whole tree based on the size of its crown.
And so you're coming out and you're counting the acorns in the baskets.
We just collect them here,
okay.
And then we take them back to the lab, and myself or some other technicians will go ahead and process them. They count them and grade them by quality, if they have insect damage, animal damage, if they're rotten, things like that. They get cut in half, and they're also weighed for biomass.
Biomass is the amount of plant material that could be used as energy or food. After researchers examine and weigh a sampling of acorns, they can estimate the forest's acorn production. Or, put another way, scientists can calculate how much food for the forest animals the oak trees will produce. That information provides an insight into the health of the forest.
This research is benefiting the people that manage the forest, the landowners, the natural resource managers, state forest people. They use our research, and it's all science-based. And these are ongoing studies. And so we have these long-term data sets, and we can actually follow the trees, 5, 6, 10, 20, our lifetime we can follow.
And that's where the science changes, from low-tech acorn counting to high-tech data crunching. The program is called the Forest Vegetation Simulator. The Forest Service makes it available to foresters in local and state governments, as well as private landowners, to help manage the forest.
So you might have a single objective of maintaining mass in your stand for wildlife production, or it might be complicated where you want to maintain mass production, but you also want to harvest some timber off the land. And so while you're trying to figure out what the optimum management scenario is for you, this model will tell you the number of acorns being produced annually based on those alternatives.
All of that information from a tiny acorn.
So now a user can use our model to look at different management scenarios over time and see how they would impact the acorn production in their forest